What does chemistry look like when you combine it with a tower defense game? That's the question I'm here to answer. I'm picking up from where I left off on the project, and the first thing I want to work on are the visuals. A few people pointed out that the atoms don't have a strong visual identity, and I agree. While there is a slight color differential in place, it's not enough on its own. I'd like to have something that's more representative of the actual nucleus of the atom. I tried a couple different approaches. The first thing I did was this script that takes a number of proton and neutron inputs and spawns these little circles for each one. I'm not totally sold on this method because there's a lot of empty space for smaller atoms, and these circles are using physics to prevent them from overlapping, which doesn't seem optimal. Given this issue, I decided to test out my newfound shader knowledge and see if I could come up with something. With the right noise and texture node settings, I got this pretty cool effect. The red circles are protons, and the blue circles are neutrons. And I made it scalable so each atom will have its own number of proton and neutron inputs. The number of circles that appear are not the exact number of nucleons, but I think this also works well because it helps demonstrate the non-deterministic nature of subatomic particles. You can see this most clearly with hydrogen, because there are multiple red circles, even though hydrogen only has one proton. Here's a collection of different atoms all together. While it's not totally evident which atoms are which just based on appearance, it's definitely an improvement from the old system. I also added these toggleable atomic symbols later on. The next visual topic I wanted to rectify are the Lewis dot diagrams. In the previous iteration, they were very inconsistent and generally incorrect, so I created a more rigorous structure for defining the bonds and atoms for different compounds. Some people suggested doing something with an electron cloud, and while I will get to this in a minute, for the compound's visuals, I wanted to stick with the Lewis dot structure because I think it's educationally valuable and I like how it looks. The new system is pretty flexible, and here are some of the revised compounds. One other small change is that I'm now considering the projectiles shot by the atoms to be photons. To make this a little more clear, now when atoms shoot, an electron temporarily jumps shells to visually present the photon firing. The last big visual change I made was a conceptual rework of the enemies. I think the suggestions to make them antimatter is a good idea. I found this cool image of hydrogen electron energy levels online, and decided to have the enemies be anti-hydrogen, and drew a few designs based on this chart. It's not all 100% conceptually cohesive, but I think it's good to have some more tie-ins to actual chemistry. Now that we've addressed some visual issues, let's get to mechanics. The first thing I really want to implement, and something a few people have also suggested, are some interactions between compounds such as explosions. I think hydrogen gas explosions are a great place to start, so let's try that. Hydrogen gas and some other gases are explosive in the presence of oxygen. So now the dihydrogen tower fires regular projectiles when it's by itself, and if we add in oxygen, then we get some explosions. I did a little more shader work and came up with this cool visual. Technically, water is formed in this explosion process, but I haven't gotten around to implementing a mechanic which uses that yet. And here's how it looks with methane. There are some other conditional explosives in chemistry as well, such as alkali metals and water. Now, sodium places traps along the track, and if there is water present, they turn into explosive mines. On the topic of water, the next mechanic I'd like to add is acid. There are a number of acidic compounds already in the game, so we just have to add a couple properties to make them unique. I gave some enemies a shield which can only be broken by acid compounds, and these compounds, such as hydrogen chloride, are enhanced by water towers. Hydrogen chloride isn't actually acidic totally by itself, but for gameplay purposes, I still gave it acid damage even when it's separate from water. A highly requested mechanic was radiation. There are a few different approaches that were suggested for how to handle it, and I decided to go with a large AoE field that does damage to everything inside of it. Now you may be wondering, which atoms have this radiation damage? Well, I could have added in atoms like uranium that would constantly have this effect, but a lot of atoms that are radioactive in their most common state don't fit super well into the combination structure I have in place. I ended up combining some ideas and used this mechanic in a way that I'll expand on in just a minute. While we're on the theme of AoE damage, I did want some kind of electron cloud attack. I decided to give this tower type to fluorine because it's the most electronegative element. And the way it works is that the electrons that are part of the Lewis dot structure orbit the atom, and each electron itself is a projectile that deals damage. There are of course some compounds that make use of this as well, but I'll leave some of those for you to explore. The next mechanic I wanted to add was some kind of slowing effect. I thought dinitrogen would be good for this because liquid nitrogen is a common science-y thing that is used for cooling. There have been a few suggestions for having different zones on the map that produce different effects. And while I haven't done anything with this yet, I think one implementation of this would be having different effects for nitrogen depending on if it's in a hot or cold zone, for example. Carbon dioxide would be another good candidate for this. I also gave that a slowing effect because dry ice is CO2, but of course it would have different properties at higher temperatures. Alright, let's return to the radiation. Another popular suggestion was to make use of isotopes. An isotope refers to the number of neutrons that an atom contains. If we look at an element on the periodic table, we see there are a few different numbers associated with the element. The top left number is the atomic number, which is the number of protons, and this is the number that really defines the element. In the upper right, we have the atomic mass, which is oddly not a whole number. It's this way because the same element can have a different number of neutrons, and these variations are called isotopes. So the atomic mass represents an average of the sum of protons and neutrons in an atom based on how common they are in nature. For example, the most common isotope of carbon is carbon-12, and because carbon has 6 protons, we know carbon-12 has 6 neutrons. This isotope structure provides an interesting basis for tower upgrades, so I made a system where you can change an atom into a higher isotope and it gains more stats. The key here is that at some point, isotopes become radioactive. Carbon-14, for example, is radioactive, so I tied in the radioactive effect from earlier, and when carbon gets upgraded twice, it gains the AoE circle around it. This bonus is only temporary because radioactive isotopes decay. In the real world, they decay into other atoms. But for now in the game, I just made it so they lose their upgrade and drop down to the previous stable isotope. To tie this all together, I added a new neutron currency, and you gain 1 neutron after every completed wave, so you have to be selective with which atoms you upgrade. Furthermore, atoms can only be upgraded when they're not part of a compound. But when upgraded atoms are added to a compound, the entire compound is upgraded as well. This system is admittedly a bit odd as it's currently implemented, but I think it provides an interesting upgrade system for people who like to min-max. To take full advantage of this upgrade system, I also expanded on how atoms are combined. A few people had proposed to have atoms combine automatically when they're in the vicinity of one another, and this is also what I imagined when I first started the project. When I thought about it a bit further, however, I realized it may be frustrating if you wanted to have some complementary atoms next to each other without forcibly combining them. So I decided to stick with the button system, but now you can use the atoms within the radius of the atom you want to combine as part of the combination. From here, I added a couple last mechanics such as poison damage for toxic atoms and compounds like arsenic. These atoms don't do any immediate damage, but they apply a stacking damage over time effect on enemies they hit. Lastly, I gave silicon the ability to unlock targeting options for surrounding atoms, and here you can see there are a few different target priorities you can choose between. The final thing I took care of was some UI polishing, and I added in a very basic tutorial level on top of reworking the enemy waves with the new enemies. Thank you everyone for the great suggestions, and I'm sorry if I missed including some of your comments in the video. I really appreciate all the recent support. I've been working on this channel full-time for a few months now, and it's something that I really enjoy and hope I can continue doing. If you want to help support me in creating these projects, just watching and interacting with the video is a great help. For those who want to give a little extra, I've started a Patreon that gives some benefits such as project files and access to exclusive content, including a Discord channel. I plan to pivot to a new project for a couple weeks, but given the amount of interest in the chemistry project, I expect to expand on it as long as people are still interested. I think there are tons of directions it can go, and I have a few ideas for where to take it next. And maybe it's something that I would put on Steam at some point. For now, if you want to try out the game, it's free to play with a link in the description. As always, thank you all for watching the video and supporting the channel. Until next time.